Hi guys, welcome to your very first 3ds Max tutorial. Hopefully this is the first of many 3ds Max tutorials. In these tutorials, we are dealing with different techniques from beginners to very advanced. This is Suman Chakravarti demonstrating this tutorial of 3D Studio Max. In today's class, we are going to discuss about the 3ds Max user interface. Okay? So, when we start this software, we don't know where to start and where to end to create the 3D animation. Okay? So, we cannot mess up things here and there. We cannot click here and there and mess the whole software. Okay, so before starting in learning this software, we have to know basic things. So first we have to know the user interface. The user interface is nothing but it's an event of tools and menus, buttons, viewports and everything. So with this we can control the software. Okay, so today we are going to learn about the 3ds Max user interface. So get ready for it. Okay, let's start. So this is the user interface of the 3ds Max. User interface is an interface where we have lots of tools and buttons and everything through which we can manipulate the software and achieve the results what we want. Okay, so in user interface, first we will discuss about the menu bar. So what we are seeing here is the menu bar. So this is called a menu bar. Every software has a menu bar. Okay, so in 3D Studio Max we have a lot of options from file. This is the file. They have created this software, people have created this as an application menu where this it contains all the menu features, okay, file menu features. Okay, so this is not named as file, but this is an application menu. Okay, is similar to file menu. Okay, so whatever you have to do with the file, you can have all these things. And about the edit, you have all the edit features, all the tools, all the groups, views, create, modify, animation, graph editor, render, customize, mask script, help. So we can discuss these things later, okay, in detail. But before that, we have to know that this file menu or this tool menu bar is the main heart of the software through which we can create things and manipulate the things. Okay, so next going through after that we have the toolbar, main toolbar. Here we have all the useful commonly used tools. Okay, in this bar we can find all the commonly used tools in this bar. Okay, we have the same things here, move, rotate, scale and everything. That's the same things we have here also. So this is then pictorial representation of the common tools we are going to use in 3ds Max now and then. Okay, so here we find a link, unlink, selection. This is the selection object. And this one is select and move, rotation, scale, and so many things. We can discuss about these things later. Okay, and apart from this, we have this one. This one is introduced in latest softwares in 3ds Max. Okay, so here we have this graphite modeling tool. This one, this set is known as Ribbon. So this contains the same features what we have in this panel. Okay, so later on we can discuss about these things, because this is the not the proper time for us to discuss these things, because you don't know anything, okay, about this. So in coming tutorials we will have a brief description of this menu bars and toolbars and the ribbons and whatever. So we are going to discuss it today in this user interface. Okay, so we have this boxes, four boxes. Can you see this? So these are four boxes. These are known as viewports. So what are viewports? Viewports are nothing but it's a place where we can see the same object in different angles. Okay, so here we have top, we have front, and we have left, and we have perspective. So what are these things? So let me draw an object here. So rather we create an object, three-dimensional object. Here I have created a cube. So don't worry about this thing. We'll later discuss how to create the objects and everything in the later classes. So here what I want to show you is that I have drawn a box. Okay, so the same box can be viewed in top view. This is the top view where we can see the object from top position. Okay, this is the front view, and here we can see the same box in front view. And here this is the side view, that is left view. Okay, we are seeing the same box in every viewport. So how many viewports do we have? We have numerous viewports. Okay, n number of viewports. But the only the thing is we have six main viewports, where we have top, bottom, front, back, left and right. These are the main viewports where we can see all the six faces of the object. Okay, six directions of the object. Okay, these six positions or views are very important to create a 3D model or do an animation or anything in three-dimensional world. Okay, and additional to this we have a perspective view, which is nothing but a three-dimensional view. Here we can see two or more sides at a time. Okay, so like this we can see this one face, other face, and this is third face. Okay, we can see three-dimensionally in this viewport. This is called 3D viewport. Okay, or we can see two, or we can see only one, but it depends on the view where through which we are seeing. Okay, so we can change this viewport, this whole viewport, to bottom. Okay, it's changed to bottom, and we can change it to front. Okay, we can change it to back, and we can change it to left, change it to right, whatever you like, because by default 3ds Max have this top viewport in this block, front viewport in this block, left viewport in these blocks, and perspective in this block. If you are not okay with the arrangement of the viewports, you can change desirably as you require. Okay, you can keep two perspective views if you want. Okay, you can have two perspective viewports if you want, and you can have two front viewports or anything wherever you want. Okay, so it's up to you. So where to place the viewports in which position? Okay, by default the viewports are staged like this. Okay, so these are the viewports. Okay, so we can later discuss about these viewports in details. Okay, in next coming tutorial classes. Okay, so next we have this lower end, this part, this whole this thing. This is the lower interface of the software. Here we have many things. These all are related to the animation. Okay, here with this all these things we can create animation, and we have this corner, bottom corner. This is viewport control panel. With these tools, we can control the way we look at the objects in the viewport. Okay, we can zoom and we can move, pan the things, whatever. So we can discuss about this panel later in the upcoming classes. And we have very major section of the software, and this contains the command panel. This thing is called command panel, and here we have more tabs. Okay, this is create panel. This is one tab, and this one is one tab. Okay, modify panel. This is hierarchy panel. This is motion panel. This is display panel. This is utility panel. So each and every tab has its own subcategories of the objects and the type of things which we can create in the 3D software. Okay, so in create panel we have standard objects, geometries and standard primitives. Okay, here we have commonly used geometries, which is helpful to make a 3D model in a better way and faster way. Okay, so we can discuss about this panel later on in the coming episodes. Okay, so these are the user interface we are having in the software. So with this we can control the software and achieve the things what we need to do, or generate a 3D graphics, animation video, or 3D model, or textured architectural visualization, animation walkthroughs, and so on. Okay, so we can discuss about these things in briefly in the coming episodes. So hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.
Please subscribe on my channel.